and James and every other person in between, we meet once again. And you already know, every opportunity I get to spend my time with you automatically becomes my favorite part of the week. Now, I promise you, we have an amazing show lined up for you today. But allow me to bust your bubble. Now, this is the crazy week, the week that we almost kind of do not like, because you're about to find out if you're a main chick, a side chick, no chick at all, or this whole time you have been painting tazamaji. It's Valentine's week. God, it's so crazy. But anyway, for all the people who are main chicks, I cannot wait to see your flowers on Instagram and like them. And then again on the show today, I have Kush Tracy. Everything is on a high today. I promise you, the tea is going to be exceptionally good. Let's get the show on the road. My name is Violet Tengin, and this is Jalango TV Extra. All right, so I promised you at the beginning of the show, the tea is going to be exceptionally good today. As you can see, we have our tea ready. We'll be sipping all through the show. And Kush Tracy, yes. The beautiful, elegant, sophisticated, classy, all those names and so much more. Yeah. Welcome to the show.
Thank you so much.
You look amazing.
I appreciate, you know, you having me come through and hang out and sip some tea. Mine is actually, you know, iced coffee. So
yeah.
Msiniulize na ibaridi ya Nairobi.
I know, right?
What is the cold?
Ask me.
We are too hot to handle.
That is how we are starting the show. I was not ready myself as well. You look very pretty.
Thank you, love. You're also looking amazing.
Thank you so much. Now, can we please get down to the tea of all matters, entertainment, and our favorite celebs? Some of them are really going crazy. No, seriously.
Yeah.
Story number one. So, yeah, Bahati. You know, I love to call him Mtoto wa Diana most times. But yeah.
Hater! No,
actually, I'm not a hater. I actually love Bahati, but sometimes he just scares me a little bit. Now, me, I'm doing my usual social media rounds, just trying to catch up with what's happening in the internet. Then, boom! He pops up in a dress, full makeup, and a blonde wig. And he is actually trying to sing like a girl. And I was confused. Yeah. Okay, what's going on? Please. I don't want to sound like a hater, but Kush, what's the deal? What's the tea? What's happening? Let me know.
I'm like, I don't know. I just feel like everyone has something they're going through and how they want to put out things out there. So for someone like him to dress up like a girl and do whatever he's doing, at this point I'm like, okay, when's the next song dropping?
Yeah.
As in, I think I'm at that point where I wouldn't like overthink about things nowadays. I'm like, okay. What's happening next?
You're just trying to get us
but
to
you
talk.
Know, hey, like you know, you're wanna simanga kila mtu at the end of the day, you've got your madness. Atujui imefika wapi. Labda wewe ni alio kuvunja basani usiku.
Yeah.
And unajua kila mtu ana zake. So, it's kind of weird. But hey, every man for inaitangwa jirani kujipa mwenyewe. Every man for himself.
Yeah.
Sisi wengine ni wapenzi watazamaji.
Yeah. But yeah, I was not ready for that one, to be honest. Yeah. I mean, there was a time he wore a dress, and I think it was that time when he was doing the flip the switch challenge.
Yeah.
And that was fantastic. I mean, it's a challenge, flip the switch, so we were all flipping outfits and all. But this one time, I think, okay, fine. When are you dropping the next song? We're ready. Yeah, we are. Literally, we are. Anyway, moving on swiftly. So, Diamond Platnumz was in the country. How we got to know about this, he actually went to Insta Stories and Instagram page and posted Nairobi in a few. Man hopes into a private jet. Soft life.
This is what
we call soft life. There's this song by Tiwa Savage. I do not come to this life to soft.
Okay.
You know, I feel like this is the song I need to be singing a big. So yeah, he comes to the country and then everyone starts talking. Is he coming to see Tanasha Donna? You know what's really going on between the two. Turns out, he had actually been paid to come and perform at a birthday party somewhere in the leafy suburbs.
Wow. Child. I'm like, I did see the picture, then I was like, oh, okay. Guys are, okay, Tanzania to Nairobi in a private jet. Hey, people are living life.
You know?
But I'm like, hapa ndo nasema ngona jua ukisema umesota. Unasema umesota wewe mwenye, unajua?
Yeah.
You talk in, from your own perspective. Like, usikaseme, ay, hakuna pesa, watu hawana pesa. Useme watu, kwa sababu watu wana pesa. Because by the time you're getting Diamond to come into Kenya on a weekend for a birthday party, not even a concert. That's what, the first time I actually thought it was a concert. So I was very shocked. Atikumbe it was a birthday party.
Yeah.
I'm like, God, what did we do wrong? You go bless us with money in 2021.
No, we need to sing. We need to sing Justin Osiokaro song. Mm. Mwaka wa restoration.
Hey, 2021.
You know?
Mwaka wa restoration.
Yes.
RSGD, we mbogani alitoa 2021, but hey.
Yeah, because when she did a song in 2020, turns out it was the worst year ever. So we were begging her not to do a song in 2021. But who is Justina?
She did, by the way. She did a song.
She did.
I just haven't heard it.
Me
but
too.
I know she did a song.
Yeah.
I think Nilo Semangante na kuitafuta nisikize. Then you forget. Mm-hmm. Then ukiongelea 20, you're like, oh, baby, kuna ngoma 2021. Yeah. Kind of crazy. But acheni Diamond ajifurahishe. Unajua, if you have money, spend it now. But you see,
at this point, it's not even him who spent the money. It's the people who actually paid him to come and paid for the jet and everything for him to be here to perform in a birthday party.
But you know, when you die, you ain't gonna carry your money. So, you know, just spend it. Spend it when you can, you know. Do the things we see in movies.
Tukakwele, what's up? Kufia ni birthday yako, unaita wantu dinner na manjili pia yo dinner. What's good?
You know? That's crazy.
But then that's the other thing. I think if you're asking people to come out for dinner, you need to pay for the entire dinner, right?
Yeah. I don't know. I always feel like it doesn't make sense.
Yeah.
You want to plan for something.
Yeah.
And you're expecting the people you're inviting to come and pay for the thing. Like, don't plan it. If you're not planning on paying, don't plan it.
Yeah, we'll just post you on Instagram. Imagine it's okay.
I know. Like, I just never understand it. Because, I've had friends of mine who are like, this baby showers, nanini. Sometimes you don't even know someone that well. Then someone is like, no, you have to send me money for...
Yeah.
I'm like, we're not even friends like that for me to send you money for your baby shower.
Yeah.
Kwani, did I get you pregnant? I did not.
Ah! Ooh. No, he's okay.
But it does make sense.
For me, I think you need to give someone a notice even before you put them in the WhatsApp group. Because
exactly.
You're just sleeping. You wake up in the morning, you're in a WhatsApp group, and there was like 100 chats overnight. You're like, okay, wait. What is happening? I'm just waking up.
Yeah.
But yeah, anyway, we digressed. But the whole point was, ukuwa pale nyumbani unasema, oh, Kenya hakuna pesa, sijui nini. Please, almost speak for yourself and your own family only.
Speak for your own pockets.
Because from the look of things, people are balling.
People are chopping
and
money.
And they have absolutely no apologies to make. Now, this is what we call the soft life, shop life. People are chopping. Mm. What are you doing? Get your right.
Chopping sukuma.
Get your act in order, okay?
Na ugali wa kikula.
All right, now, okay, moving on again. Now, yeah, like I said at the beginning of the show, it's Valentine's week.
Yeah.
It's a crazy week. Because, you know, in this week, you get to find out where you lie in this
land spectrum.
You know, where are you? So are you main chick, side chick?
Yeah.
Come with smash chick. Mm-hmm. No chick at all.
Booty call chick.
Booty call chick.
Yeah. I'm a one night stand.
Yeah,
chick.
I'm a pens in Tazamaji.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So this is a crazy week.
Yeah.
And you know, most of the men have already now started going crazy with the men's conference kind of conversations because they're trying to run away from the whole idea of it's Valentine's Day. Worse still, it's falling on a weekend.
Yeah.
You have no excuse that, baby, I'm busy at work. It's a Sunday or more. Mm-hmm. Yeah? So do you think the men who really throw around the men's conference jokes or those who say, you know, this day is actually not significant, do you think they have a right to do so, or they're just running away from just being a gentleman and using this day to go a little bit the extra mile for this woman? This
I feel like for most guys who are using the initiative, the men's conference thingy, It's either you just haven't found the one, or you're not sure about the one you're with, or you're just a man of a, that's a very bad word, you're a player.
Yeah.
And you have a couple of women, so you don't want to be with a particular woman on that day.
Because the other woman is going to,
Exactly. Yeah. And also that means, maybe you're special than the others you get. So I feel for most men, it's more of njia ya kuhepa, iyo kupata the title.
Mm.
Yeah, okay, kumbe, we are official or we are, you know, because those questions will come in on that particular day.
Yeah.
If you are with a particular person. But I feel it's the same thing with ladies. By the time you find a lady somewhere with someone on the exact date, either that lady wants that person, they do actually have real feelings for them, or they are hoping to have a future with them.
Mm-hmm.
But kawaida pia wanawake, atusemangi women's conference, but kuna venye tu mademu kwanga tu anaenda mitini. Then you won't see on social media, you won't know where she's at, what she's doing, whom she's with.
Yes.
But you know, she's just going to exit herself. Like, because I know this person likes me, but I don't, it's not the same.
Yeah.
I can't reciprocate the same love or the same affection you have towards me.
Yeah.
So, and like for men, it's basically you fear love, or you're just not ready, or you just still
not
want
sure.
to have a couple of women, and you know, you're trying to use this as an excuse.
Yeah.
But I just find it so immature. I'm like, you know, I think deep down everyone wants to be loved. Everyone wants to have that one person you can talk to, you can go home to, you can, you know, spend time with. Like, I don't know. I just really want to talk about love, like in Ile Nivenye. We've been disappointed too many times to a point sometimes it's hard for you to learn or relearn how to love, how to trust from my personal experience. Like, it's, you just get to that point.
And then also at the end of the day, usisahau jiji ni gani?
Jiji ni Nairobi.
Jiji ni Nairobi.
Hey.
You know this city, you have to tread carefully.
Kuna watu wako already say blocked.
What?
What time block you are?
The conversation 20th. Archived.
Exactly.
Archived. Conversation archived.
Hey.
No.
It's what crazy though.
What's wrong with this city though? Is it so hard to find love in the city, really?
I just feel like it's more of the decisions people make, and it's a mentality thing. Like, you know, it's cool to just be a player. It's cool to be messing around with different women.
Yeah.
And like I say, like every day there are new ones who are being born.
Yeah.
And of course, after when you're going to have to watatokea. And for men, I feel like for men, they need to be very intentional about everything they're doing. Because, you know, at some point, whatever you're doing right now, whatever energy you're putting out, it's going to come back and maybe affect your daughter.
And
she'll
women
go
too.
Through, exactly.
And women too.
You know, because whatever you're doing to someone's daughter out there, karma is a...
And always been.
It's exactly. And it's going to come back to you in one way or another. So sometimes you wonder why things are happening, and kumbo mesau, like the things you're doing to other people, they're the things which are coming back to you.
Yeah.
But I feel like we can find love. But men need to be more intentional, and this thing for, I don't know, the more the number of, I don't know, it's body count, the number of women you are having.
Speaking of body count, at what point
it's not even cool
to, like, at what point did it become cool talking about your body count in public? Because I see people mentioning the numbers and they're laughing about it, and I'm like, honey, I think you need to be doing a walk of shame. If I mean,
but it's not cool. I think we need to normalize having, like, you know, one woman whom you treat right, whom you're with, who you stick by, like being normal, like that's now cool, because that means you have to have a lot of discipline, you need to be very intentional about everything you're doing, and that makes you a whole man, where no woman, no matter what they look like, whatever shape they come in, whatever they're wearing, whatever complexion they are, that doesn't get to you. You're like, you know what, I got my lady. Like, How cool is that?
I know, right?
How cool is that?
Yeah, that's all we all want. But at the end of the day,
Nairobi.
You know, you have to stay on your toes.
Yeah.
But here's the thing, guys. Just the same way we have Mother's Day on a particular day, it doesn't mean that we don't appreciate our moms all through the year.
Yeah,
we also have Father's Day. You know, we have National Sibling Day. You appreciate your siblings every year throughout the year. So it's just the same thing. This is one particular day set aside to really go overboard for this particular person. So don't make it look like, oh, so all these other things we do for you when it's not Valentine's, it doesn't matter. Treat it the same way you treat Mother's Day, okay? Have you ever had a bad experience on Valentine's Day yourself?
Do you know, but I've never had, like,
really?
You see, they were saying the women's conference. The women who also have a conference that has never existed.
Yeah.
I'm those people.
Ah.
Like, I've never, for me, Valentine's, for me, I feel like it needs to be special, you get. And it's okay, it's unfortunate I've never, like, been with someone on Valentine's.
Oh, no.
Like, I've always been single, in one way or another. Yeah.
Aww.
Like, I've never, like, had, like, had Valentine's with someone special and all that. That never happened. But for me, I feel like when it comes to having such a day, it has to be with someone who's, someone that I love, someone that I'm looking, like, at things from a very different perspective. Not just, it's not just about the fun, it's more of, you know, life, doing life together, and just a lot of things.
Okay.
So for me, such a day is going to be very special.
Mm-hmm.
That's why I'd rather, if we're situation shipping out here, I'm like, I'll see you on 15th or I'll see you on 13th.
Yes.
Not that particular day, because I don't want to give people the, like, the wrong impression. Like, maybe I'm here and you get. I'm like, I'd rather stay at home, chill, and watch a movie. And
what you just did is give people in situationships your date. So, 14th is for people in exclusive relationships, okay? Like, we are together. The whole world knows that we are together. Situationships, You know, situationship is a situation where we are together, but we are not together.
Yeah, and it's not defined.
You know, you get like great areas all over the place, but you are mine. Yeah. But still, you're not mine. Mm-hmm. So for the people in situationships, your day is on the 13th and the 15th.
Don't get confused. Don't get it twisted.
Yeah. Don't congest the day for the people who are in serious, exclusive relationships.
Yeah.
So you have 5 days to go. You better find someone until then. Okay, are we together?
Me is off the market, you know, so I ain't trying to look. Sure. I'm like talking from my previous experiences.
Wow.
But I'm
look at you.
A girl ain't looking. Trust me. Me is good.
Yeah, but you're glowing. It's easy to tell that you're in a happy relationship. Please stay in love.
Love is good. Yeah. Love is good. I think we all need some love. Like Jesus. Yeah. We need some love.
I'm happy for you.
Yeah.
Yeah. I'll be there double tapping your flowers, your vacation, wherever it is that you're going. You know, I'll just be there like, oh, look at you. Must be nice.
Oh.
Yeah. I wish you all the best, Mama. Alright, now let's get down to other things that people want to know about you. Kush Tracy, you are a TV presenter, you are a fashion enthusiast, you're a content creator, you're a singer. You do so much, right? Mm-hmm. And you got our attention after you got into the music space. Mm-hmm. Right, and you got into the music space doing secular music, and then at some time you transitioned into gospel music, and then now people have a lot of questions as to whether you are actually still doing gospel music or you are back to secular music. And you know, pretty much, you know, bloggers love to create stories and make things look like, you know, what they really are not, right? Mm-hmm. So there was a picture of you in a club some time back. Not so long ago. Mm-hmm. I mean, just a girl having a good time, just turning up with her own money, looking fly and all. And then I think that is where most of the conversation started, like, oh, Kush Tracy is back to her old lifestyle. Mm-hmm. What do you have to say about that?
I'm like, I feel like at the end of the day, everyone is always going to judge you one way or another. Yeah. Probably you don't like my makeup, you don't like my hairstyle, you don't like my shoes, you don't like the way I dress, you don't like the way I speak, you don't like my voice, you don't like my music. You get, like, you'll always have something to say. And when it comes to God, this is one thing I always say, I'll never argue with a human being in regards to God. Like, I can't have that conversation. At least he argued you are God. Like, who are you for me to argue with you about God? Like, who are you? You get?
Mm-hmm.
And people will always judge you, whether you're doing right or you're doing wrong.
Mm-hmm.
And one thing I said, I'll never fake being a Christian for the sake of money. I'll never fake being a Christian for the sake of hype. I'll never. I'll live my life. But if you listen to anything I say, even when I'm walking in whatever, God is my first love.
Mm-hmm.
I talk about him all the time. I'm very passionate about God. I'm like, yes, I'm not one. I'm those imperfect soldiers of Christ. But my relationship with God, it's a whole different thing. And I'm like, you know, for human beings, by the time you're judging me, how perfect is your life? If you call yourself a Christian, do you live like Jesus?
Mm-hmm.
Do you? You get? Mm-hmm. Or Nile too, you're just, you know, parading yourself out here in the name of, oh, I'm saved, oh, I'm Sijuinini, oh, I'm Nini. But you are the devil himself behind closed doors when people don't even see.
Mm-hmm.
Like, out here people, you know, you can fake it out here, but you can't fake it from in here when it comes to God. He knows your intentions, he knows why you're doing what you're doing, he knows what you're going through, he knows things that no one will ever understand. And at the end of the day, I'm like, you know what, yes, I've always known my path is in it's very aligned to God. My path, my destiny, I understand it. I'm not there yet, but that's where my destiny is at. So everything else I'm doing in between here, one day you'll get to understand it better when I'll decide to talk about my journey from a very honest and from a deeper level. Right now I don't. I just, you know, right now I'm just saying, hey, hey, hey. But the day I'll decide to talk about it, that's when people will get to understand what was happening. And I'm very sure a lot of people will be able to relate from everything that I say. And at the end of the day, it will be able to change so many lives.
Okay.
So for now, I'm not looking at, you know, mambo ya pevi juju. But trust you me, my path as a person, my destiny is not in any shebang that I'm doing right now. It's very much aligned to God, spiritually, to Jesus, too. So I'm very much saved. If you're concerned, very much saved. Ni begeto, I'm not 100% yet, but I'm headed there. It's a journey. It's a process. You can just drop everything. It's hard, sometimes you get tempted, and everything, but at the end of the day, it's your intention, what you want. Do you understand what God wants you to do? Because by the time you choose to get saved, you just don't, you get. there's a lot of conviction, there's a lot of things going on, there's a lot of self-talk when you're alone. You sit like this, you talk to God, yet there's so much that happens in your mind, in your spirit, in your heart, and these things you just don't tell anyone. You don't even talk about them, but you yourself, you know. So by the time you make such a decision, you already know why you're making that decision. And like I said, my path as a person, my destiny is aligned to God, to Jesus, to Christianity. And I'm not there yet, but that's why I say, for now, take what is good, leave what is bad.
Yes.
You get. You see me somewhere, I'm like, hey, Iyo si ya Mungu. Like, I know, you get, like, it's those things, yes, you're doing, but you know very well, they're not God ordained, they're not godly. Same thing if I start talking about someone. I very much know it's wrong for me to talk about someone, but why do we keep on talking about people? You get? Mm-hmm. Why do we feel like we have to be very opinionated about people?
Yeah.
But you know, we know, look, kuja kwa Mungu, this is not the right thing. You get what I'm saying?
Totally,
so at the end of the day, it's all about, again, it's all about the decisions that you make and the person that you are. But I believe in just, you know, being real. I'm always like, for me, being real is the one thing that's very stagnant in my life. Mm-hmm. I'm like, yeah, I mess up papa kule and all that. Mm-hmm. But I do understand my journey, and I'm working towards getting there.
All right.
So I'm still in the process.
Yeah.
When we get there, then everyone will understand other things.
Okay.
But yeah.
So should we expect anything from you when it comes to music?
Of course, yeah. You can never just stop singing. You know, I know I've taken a break since, when was this? 2019 is the last time I did music. Last year I didn't get into studio. Mm-hmm. And that's why I'm saying, by the time I'll start talking about these things from a deeper level, people will be able to understand. Mm-hmm. It's easy for me to go into studio right now, because I've had producers who are like, yo, kuna beat, metumiwa, there's, you know, come to studio, we have a session and all that. It's so easy for me to go and decide to jump onto the Gengetone wave. Why? Because that's what I used to do with Kidadandia. That was Gengetone venye, haikuwa na jina, naikuwa ngime shikakasa, you get. But at the end of the day, that's what I say, when it comes to a relationship between someone and God, it's deeper than a normal human being can understand. That's why I can't go, like, literally, I'll write my whatever, I'll write the lyrics, but they can't come out. I can't go to a booth and record it, because my spirituality, this is not what you're supposed to be doing.
Yes.
This is not the music. But why do I feel like I want to do that music? Because it's the music that will work for me, you know, the hype, the, you know, getting back into doing gigs and what. But understanding the fact that this is not the path you're supposed to be on, you need to work towards the path you're supposed to be on, gives me peace.
And that requires a total level of honesty.
Exactly. You have to be very honest with yourself, because it's so easy to just go with the wave. It's very easy to go with the wave. And listening, you know, to people that, why are you not doing this? Can we do this? Can we do this? But I'm like, at the end of the day, I don't play with God. I'm like, everything that I am, everything that I've been through and God has pulled me through, there is a level of respect, and it's too deep for me for me to just do some other things. All That's how I'm like, you know, like, hey, ni. But honestly speaking, nimengangana kwenda kwa studio kufanya hizo mziki inakataa. It's a struggle.
Yeah.
As in, it's actually a struggle.
Yeah.
I can't, like,
imekataa.
Ile nitazimbia hapa, but I can't.
Yeah.
It's a struggle.
So when someone listens to you talking about your spiritual journey and your relationship with God, it's evidence that you have a total intense respect for God, and you're very much connected to that spiritual side of you.
Yeah.
Is this the upbringing you got growing up, or is this something you developed in your life growing up as an adult, or this has been your life?
I always say we all have a purpose in this world. You know, sometimes the path is not clear, sometimes the plan is not, like, you know, evident, sometimes you don't know, life happens, things happen, but my mom has always been a very prayerful person, and I saw that, you know, growing up and all that. But like I say, if you're very honest with yourself, and you know, when it comes to spirituality, it's very different from religion. Unaweza kwa wewe ni msomi kwa unapelekwa kanisa kazote every Sunday, you're in church and all that, but are you spiritually connected to, you know, do you know when God is speaking to you? Do you know when you get, like, it's deeper. That's what I'm saying, for a normal human being, you wouldn't be able to understand it if you're not a spiritual person. So for me, it's more of, you know, those things you've always known from the content I listen to. Honestly speaking, I, even when I'm driving, I listen to Christian music. It's just like automatically I listen to Christian music. I listen to preachings, I listen to inspiration and motivation. I just I can't seem to listen to anything else. Mm-hmm. But when I go out and we're out there having fun, that's the only time I get to listen to these other things.
Oh, yeah?
To the secular side of it, okay. You get. Even when I used to go to studio. Mm-hmm. Like, by the time I'm getting to the studio, you find me, I'm listening to very deep stuff,
yeah,
that is not even related to what I'm going to record in studio.
Yeah.
So you get it. You getting to that point where you are very honest with yourself,
mm-hmm,
and you listen to those, you know, it's an inner voice,
mm-hmm,
something you have like to learn how to hear it,
mm-hmm,
how to understand it. And I won't lie, it's hard. That's as much as like I'd want to live this way,
mm-hmm,
I'm still out here, but you get,
mm-hmm,
but still it comes, you know, with your environment, to the people you're around,
mm-hmm,
you know, the work that you do,
mm-hmm,
and everything else,
yeah.
But kila kitu ni pole pole. I tell people like spirituality is not easy. It
no,
ain't.
It's not. All right.
But it's, you know, it's you and God at the end of the day.
Yeah,
I'm like,
yeah.
Where's ifuresha binadamu wote? Unajua hata kwa like, mbona nini? Why are you wearing a short dress? Why are you blah blah blah? I'm like, you know what? I can't even start fighting with y'all. I'm like, you know what? That's your opinion. That's your, you know, that's how you feel about me. And I'm like, I could care less about how you feel about me. I'm how you see me.
Yeah.
But ya muhimu ni your relationship with the man above.
All right.
Yeah.
So many young girls are watching you right now. Some of them, if not all, draw inspiration from you. They're watching you on Switch TV every day, doing your deed, Palette Chat Sports. They're looking
yeah
at you on your Instagram, living life to the fullest. They're hearing you speak right now about your spirituality, and they're drawing a lot of inspiration from you. What can you tell a young girl who's trying to find her path and put her foot somewhere in the mm-hmm world right now?
What I can say, life happens.
Mm-hmm.
Things will go left,
mm-hmm,
very quick. And you won't be able to know how you can, you know, handle or maneuver around it, and get things to go the way you want them to go.
Uh-huh.
And people are going to walk in and out of your life.
Uh-huh.
People are going to lie to you. People are going to deceive you. People are going to play with your emotions. People are going to play with your mind. People are going to tell you so many things. You get. And it's okay. You're going to go through a lot of things. A lot of emotions, a lot of heartbreak, not even from relationships alone, but even heartbreak from just everything that's going on, you get. Like, it's not just about the relationship.
Yeah.
Sometimes your heart can break in so many ways and you can't even explain it because it's not at your man who's making you feel that way,
yeah,
you get. So many things will happen to you, and it's okay to not be okay. It's okay to get to that point where you feel like, I'm just tired of this life. Because me, I got to that point, I was very suicidal at some point, and I even tried it, but oh, Mungu ni nani? Niliamkatuni kiwana kichwa nikani kwa nimeenda dunda nikakunywa mzinga peke yangu. And I hadn't, like literally.
So how did you, what did you try to do?
No, I tried pulling the painkillers thing, but the headache I had the next day, I was like, why did I even do this?
How many tablets did you take?
I can't even remember.
It
I think I did a lot, yeah.
So did you mix them up or did you know?
No,
what?
I think I did,
mm-hmm,
some painkillers. In like extreme, extreme, extreme.
Mm-hmm.
But anyway, story for another day. But so, like I said, it's okay to get to that point. You have those emotions, those
mm-hmm
feelings. That's what I say, for me, my spirituality is what has really helped me in so many ways.
Mm-hmm.
You get through the heartaches, through the heartbreaks, through the pain of life, you know, through the disappointments.
Mm-hmm.
My spirituality is the only thing. It's not even religion could never have helped me.
Yeah.
It's my spirituality.
Uh-huh.
Understanding there's a deeper purpose. Understanding you can't just lose faith like that.
Uh-huh.
You get. Like you just can't lose hope because you've seen God move things in a very weird way.
Uh-huh.
So it's that reminding myself, you know, this is what has happened and it's gonna be okay. You get.
Uh-huh.
Like the things it's pulled you through. Like it, you start remembering those things. You still have hope for the
yeah
next day and for a better future.
Right.
But things are gonna go crazy and it's okay to feel some type of way. It's okay to feel lost. It's okay to make the mistakes you're making or the ones you've made. It's okay. Because at the end of the day, one thing about God, he'll give you another chance to redeem yourself, to become a better person, to become a different person. See, it's not even about anyone else's opinions, oh, they'll judge me, oh, they'll find out what. Me, I'm always judged 24/7. But you can't put that in your mind,
mm-hmm,
you get.
Mm-hmm.
Let them judge, they'll go to sleep,
mm-hmm,
and life moves on. Because
mm-hmm
at the end of the day, the person who's judging you, they also have their own issues.
Yeah.
It's just that they feel better when they're judging someone else because
yeah
it makes them forget the issues that they
have
as a person. You know, it's like I'm trying to it's clothe my nakedness
uh-huh
by taking your clothes.
Yeah.
You get.
Yeah.
It's like it's something of that sort.
Yeah.
So it's okay. Like, it's okay, and you're going to be okay. All right. That's what I can say.
What do you think is the most common misconception that people have about you?
I think a lot of people just have so many misconceptions about me. Mm-hmm. I recently got that question, mm-hmm. and I was like, I think people just have a lot of misconceptions about me. Mm-hmm. You know, at the end of the day, sometimes circumstances make us behave very differently.
Yeah.
Sometimes the environment makes you behave very differently. Mm. But a lot of people think they know me, but honestly, they don't. Because there's me that people know from out here. There's this personality of mine, which is bubbly, very energetic. But anyone that knows me closely, they know I'm not even a people's person. I'm not, like, I'm an introvert. I'm those people that I'd want to come sit alone. I don't mind my company. I'm okay. But I still, when I'm around people, they'll still, like, you get, like, I have very different personalities, but I feel like at the end of the day, my personalities depend with where I'm at, who I'm with, and what I'm doing.
Yeah.
So I just feel like people just think they know me, but they don't. Honestly speaking, they don't know me.
Right.
You get, like, and you can't explain to people things that they can't even understand themselves. So, hey.
And it is
this
what
is
it
life.
Is.
Yeah, yeah, you know, you're like, you know, it is what it is.
All right.
Yeah.
Thank you so much for coming through.
Thank you
so
much.
I wish you a blissful Valentine's Day.
Thank you.
Please enjoy. Stay in love. We love to see it. The tea was exceptionally hot today. I hope you had yourself a fantastic time. I definitely enjoyed talking to Kush Tracy. See you later in the week with so much more. My name is Valentine, and of course, this is Jalango TV Extra. Ciao.